Hi guys, what's up? What's going on? Hope you are good. In this video, I want to show you how you can deposit and withdraw across various blockchain networks. And this video became very necessary because I got a couple of my students asking me on how they can deposit and withdraw funds with the various blockchain networks that we have, such as BEP2, BEP20, BSC, ERC20, and so many others. Okay? So before I start, kindly subscribe to this channel if you haven't done so, so that you don't miss any of my educative videos on trading, investing, and online business. And without further ado, let's dive in. Okay, so the first thing you need to know when it comes to depositing and withdrawing across blockchain networks is that you need to understand cryptocurrency very well. And the simple definition that I give about cryptocurrency is that they are digital assets that you can truly own. And why can you truly own them? It's because these digital assets are scarce. They have limited supply. Most of them have limited supply. And because of mathematics, because of cryptography, if you buy one, you can truly own them due to public key and private key cryptography. So if you buy one and you have it in your wallet, you truly own it. Nobody else has that one in the entire supply. So right now the world is going virtual. Most things are going virtual and people now prefer to, you know, have their wealth in what? Cryptocurrency that are truly scarce. Okay, so the next thing you need to understand is what? Blockchain. Every cryptocurrency has its own blockchain, has its own blockchain network. And a blockchain is just a database that is on a network of computers. So each cryptocurrency, for example Bitcoin, the database that is the history of all the transactions is not on a single server. It's on a network of various computers across the world. They're not even in a single country. They are dispersed across the world. So if you come over to a platform called coinmarketcap.com, you are going to see there that we have, if you check the main page, you have the list of the 100 top cryptocurrencies, and each of these cryptocurrencies has its own blockchain network. Bitcoin has its own, the Bitcoin network. Ethereum has its own, the ERC20, that's the Ethereum network. Binance has its own, and even Binance has another network, another blockchain network called Binance Smart Chain. They even have Binance DEX, that decentralized exchange. Tether also has its own network. Cardano has its own. Polkadot has its own. Okay, so basically, all this network of cryptocurrency, Bitcoin, Ethereum, USDT, BNB, we are going to be looking at their network and how to, you know, deposit and withdraw from them. So let me start with Bitcoin. So for Bitcoin, if you come to withdraw, let's come to withdraw. So I will show you all the network that is available. Okay, so if I want to withdraw Bitcoin here, for example, I have the option to withdraw Bitcoin to how many network can you see here? I have about 4 network here. So now the first network that we are seeing here is the what? Okay, before I even start with the first network, what is the Bitcoin network? If you want to withdraw to another Bitcoin wallet like Paxful, if you want to withdraw to another Bitcoin wallet like Paxful, Luno, or even your own mobile hosted wallet, yeah, what you're going to choose, or the most advisable, is what? The Bitcoin network. The Bitcoin network, that's the most advisable, okay? Because Bitcoin has the Bitcoin network, but we also have some other network that you can send to. And how are these done? I've told you, cryptocurrency are digital assets that, you know, their history or their database is on a network of what? Computers. So for example, let's start with Ethereum. Ethereum network is called ERC20. Okay, so if you come to the Ethereum network, if you come to Etherscan, ethereum.io, which gives you information about the Ethereum blockchain and the Ethereum network. As you can see here, you can see the Ethereum price. You can also see I want to see the number of tokens. Okay, so okay, there's a place I can see. Okay, it has 20 view. Yes, okay. So you can also create your own token. Okay, so for example, Ethereum or Ether, which runs on the Ethereum blockchain. Let's go and look at Ethereum. Okay, so for example, Ethereum that we have this is Ethereum blockchain, for example. Okay, so now what I want you to know here is that you can also send Bitcoin on the what Ethereum blockchain, and how does it work? It's called tokenized Bitcoin, because if you send Bitcoin across the Ethereum blockchain, that means you are sending ETH Bitcoin. Now it's now a tokenized Bitcoin. Okay, so if you are sending Bitcoin, you don't want to send it to a Bitcoin network that you have. If you have a Bitcoin wallet, that's the Bitcoin network. But let's say you have an Ethereum wallet that you have the what, the seed phrase, an Ethereum wallet that you created. If you have taken my course, you know how to create a what, a self-hosted wallet. So let's say you created an Ethereum wallet, a raw Ethereum wallet. For example, if you come to my ether wallet.com and you created a raw Ethereum wallet, on my ether wallet.com. Sorry, it's still loading. So you can use that, you can send Bitcoin to that what raw Ethereum network, Ethereum wallet, by using the Ethereum network. Okay, so if you are choosing the Ethereum network, this network you have selected is ERC20 BBTC. Please ensure that the withdrawal address supports the ERC20 BBTC. You will potentially lose your assets if the chosen platform does not support refund of wrongfully deposited address. So if you come to my Ether wallet and you create a new wallet, so if you create a new Ethereum wallet via a phrase, and you store all this, way you have this phrase, you have a raw Ethereum wallet that you can import or export across network, you can send Bitcoin to such address and you'll be able to access it. We also have what we call the Binance Smart Chain. You can also send Bitcoin towards a Binance Smart Chain, but they wrote it, to ensure that your withdrawal request is accepted, please complete these three questions prior to selecting BSC. Have you confirmed that the platform or application you are withdrawing to support BSC network? Yes, I have confirmed. Okay, so if you have confirmed, now to have the Binance Smart Chain network, you can use Trust Wallet, okay, or you can configure your MetaMask. You can also create Ethereum account using MetaMask. Okay, and you can also configure your MetaMask, which is for Ethereum. You can configure it to use the what, the Binance Smart Chain. I've configured mine. So another thing you can do is to install the Binance Smart Chain wallet. This is Binance Smart Chain wallet. You can install the Chrome extension. So if you have this Binance Smart Chain wallet, you can also send Bitcoin to what? To it. So I have it here already. I have a Binance Smart Chain wallet here, which I can unlock and what? Send Bitcoin to. And I also have it on my what? On my Trust Wallet on my phone, which I can also send Bitcoin to. Okay, that's the Binance Smart Chain wallet, okay? So you need to know the kind of wallet you have before you withdraw Bitcoin to any of them. We also have the Binance chain, which was the first chain that Binance created, but it wasn't successful. This is a decentralized exchange, so it wasn't successful, and like a lot of people don't use it, okay? So this is the major network that you're going to be seeing if you want to withdraw or deposit Bitcoin. So before you withdraw to any of these wallets, know the ones that you have. If you have Bitcoin wallet, maybe on Luno, on Paxful, on blockchain.com, or you have the self-hosted wallet on your device. Maybe you created a raw wallet on Jax or Coinomi. If you have the Bitcoin wallet, you choose Bitcoin. Now, if you want to choose ETH, you need to make sure, if you want to choose Ethereum network, you need to make sure that is an Ethereum wallet that you have the pass phrase that you can import and export. If you created an Ethereum wallet on MetaMask or my Ether wallet, you have the seed phrase. If you send Bitcoin there, you can be able to import your wallet elsewhere and also send the Bitcoin back, okay? The same thing with the Binance Smart Chain. Before you send Bitcoin to the Binance Smart Chain, make sure that you have a Smart Chain wallet, whether through this plugin, or on Trust Wallet, okay? So that's that. And the major reason why people use different networks is because some network has cheaper fees. Binance Smart Chain, for example, currently has the cheapest fee. If you are sending Bitcoin via the Bitcoin network, current fee is $29. And $29 is about 14,000 Naira. If you are sending Ethereum, it's about $19, which is about 10,000 Naira. But look at it, if you are using the Binance Smart Chain, the Binance Smart Chain is the cheapest, $0.24. And that's why people use it. So let's say I want to withdraw USDT, for example. The USDT coin or cryptocurrency, for example, has its own native blockchain. Bitcoin has its own blockchain as BTC, and the same way USDT has its own blockchain as Tether or Omni. We call it Omni, okay? That's its own native blockchain. But people use different network. So people use different network so that they can send and receive at a cheaper fees. So now, if you are sending Tether to Ethereum, it's just you having a tokenized Tether on the Ethereum blockchain, okay? So what people just did is they created exact amount of some Tether that they have. Maybe they have, you know, this is more like a custodial service, okay? So if I'm the creator of a Bitcoin on Ethereum, wrapped Bitcoin, if I have 100 Bitcoin, I can tell people I have 100 Bitcoin, okay? So this 100 Bitcoin, I've created a token called Bitcoin on Earth, that's wrapped Bitcoin. So now I have the 100 Bitcoin, this is it. Now you can be trading my own wrapped Ethereum, okay? So if you want to send it, what you'll be receiving is a tokenized Ethereum, okay? So tokenized Bitcoin on Ethereum. So if you send to the Ethereum wallet, this Bitcoin is going to arrive there, okay? And you can also send it back. They will receive it on Binance. So you can also send USDT via Binance Smart Chain, okay? You can also send it via Binance Smart Chain. I even have a Binance Smart Chain wallet which I can send here, and we can give it a trial, okay? So on my mobile device, I have a Binance Smart Chain wallet here on my mobile device. So I have a Binance Smart Chain wallet on my mobile device, and I can also send some USDT to it, okay? I can also send some USDT to my Binance Smart Chain wallet, okay? So we also have what we call the TRC20 network. You can also send USDT to the TLC20 network. And as you can see here, the fees for the TLC20 network is very cheap. It's just slightly higher than the Binance Smart Chain. And that's why most people have been using TLC20 to send USDT across exchange. For example, I use KuCoin. If I want to send USDT to KuCoin, I wouldn't use Tether Omni or Ethereum ERC20 because their fees is very high, 20 USDT and 20 USDT. I would just use TLC20 and they charge me 1 USDT. So what I just need to do is go to KuCoin, or even go to, maybe you want to buy USDT from me, I'll just tell you to go to Binance and what? Go to deposit on Binance. Okay, go to deposit on Binance. Choose USDT as what you want to deposit. And choose which network. Choose the TLC20 network. And you copy it and you send to me. So if you send this address to me, what I just need to do is come to my withdraw. Come to my what? So I'll choose USDT here. And I'll paste the address here. And automatically, okay, the address matches a Tron network address. Please select the correct network you wish to make the withdrawal on. So this is it, Tron network. So if I should send this USDT, they will charge me $1 and it's going to arrive in that what address. So you can use it to send across exchanges. So what I just want you to understand is that, you see, all this network, you can use it to send cryptocurrencies across, and some networks are cheaper than the other, but you have to always double check the network before you send. Double check. Once again, I'll reiterate, if you are sending to Tron, that wallet that you have, do you have the seed phrase? And exchanges use this a lot, because exchanges, most of them, they have it. So make sure that you verify very, very well. So if you are withdrawing USDT and you are withdrawing it to Binance Smart Chain, make sure that, okay, you have the Smart Chain enabled wallet. If you are withdrawing to Ethereum, make sure you have an Ethereum that you have the seed phrase so that you can access those funds and what, send it, okay? So that's just that. The most important thing is the wallet that you have and which blockchain network does wallet support. MetaMask, for example, supports Ethereum. It also supports Binance Smart Chain if you can configure it. Okay, so let me try to log in here on one of my accounts and show you. Let's go to the Binance Smart Chain. So like right now, this is a Binance Smart Chain account, and it's even an Ethereum account. It's an Ethereum account that I configured on the Binance Smart Chain, and this can receive. Okay, so I know it's a little bit complicated, but you know, with time, you know, you get this. Okay, so don't forget, the Binance Smart Chain is what is compatible with the Ethereum network, and that's why we have Ethereum addresses that can work on Binance Smart Chain if you can what configure it. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. If you have any question, kindly put it down in the comment section below, and before you leave, kindly like and subscribe to this channel so that you don't miss any of our educative videos on trading, investing and online business. Also hit the doorbell button so you get notified, and until next time, keep learning, my friend. Bye.